All right, boys, day six. Here we are. The day is getting away from me. It's already like 9:30, 10 o'clock. The boys are in here working. We're getting stuff done. And I'm like, yeah, still got a vlog. Let's go check out what's done. Fabbing up some patches for the old fender. That's still going good. That's gonna be his top for that piece there. A little trimming, little cutting, little fabbing. All right, we pretty much got this fender 100% beat out. It's still gonna need just some light little loving from the top side now, but there is no more dents in this fender. It looks so much better. You can see the marks on the back where we beat it, but we still gotta do something about this. This will probably end up getting cut out and patched here because it's already busting on this side. But as far as the dents and how well that cleaned up, it's that good, it's that quick. This thing is pretty much ready for, you know, minus this, it's ready to finish sandblasting around the edge, throw some epoxy primer on it, a couple coats of high build, and probably block that thing out with hardly no filler. We'll have a little bit of filler once we cut that out there, and you've got to Duraglass your seams, so you're going to have a little filler there always. But this one, boy, I got my work cut out for me on this one. You can see down it. It's rough. Nice little gouge here. Big dip here. So that's what we're gonna set up this camera here and start beating some of these out. A little hammer and dolly action. All right, as we're tapping these out, you can see, I don't know if you guys could tell just how wavy it was before, but you can really tell now that the dents are coming out, because everywhere there was a dent, there was filler, and we kind of left that in there. And now as we hit it from the backside, it's busting that out. So I know I'm getting close here. All I gotta do is just keep whacking at it. You can really see the low spots there. There's no reason to, I mean, if you're going to paint it, you might as well just try to beat some of these dents out. It really doesn't take that much extra time, in my opinion, as it does to keep sanding and blocking and filling this stuff. I mean, you've seen the amount of filler that was on this stuff. And that was just a result of all the dents and dings that they had to keep filling and then level it all out. So if you just get down to bare metal and get that them dents out, it makes life simple. It really does. All right, guys, we've beat on this for a while, and I've got about probably a quarter of it done. It's probably, I just want to go over kind of my method, or kind of how, what I do, or my, you know, the steps I take. So I basically just beat out the dent from the backside to the best of my ability. And you really don't need a dolly for that. It helps to hold it out there if you're not familiar with it. And the only thing that dolly is doing is keeping you from overstretching that metal. So you basically just hold it on there flat and beat it from the backside. Now, you can also do it from the other way if the dent's going the other way. Because sometimes these dents, when they're pressed in here, let's say, around that dent will actually be high. So you'll beat that out. You'll want to hold your dolly. But then you're going to, after you beat it out, you're going to have a high spot across the whole thing. So then you're going to want to take this to the backside of the metal and lightly tap that down from the front. Now, if they're too bad, sometimes you got to add heat, you know, and a cooling rag to heat, you know, to shrink the material or whatever. Most cases you can get by with just a hammer and dolly, in like 99% of cases. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm just gonna keep whacking along at it. Dolly on the back, dolly on the front, hammer, hammer, hammer. For probably another hour or two on this thing, because it's so beat up. There's just so many big dips. And this is old school. This is a 47, this is real metal, okay? This ain't that 21 gauge or whatever they're using now. This is serious, like 17, 18 gauge. It's thick, so we're gonna keep at it. All right, guys, fenders are nice and straight. I've beat them to death. They are nice and straight. Louis said he's tired of hearing me hammering today. So we're gonna go ahead and move on to something else. So today's gonna be, well, the rest of the day, what we got left of it. I got to cut this back off here, there, where we tacked it. And then we're gonna start removing these boards. They gotta come out to go to the sandblaster, and this thing has to go. So we don't want them chewing up our wood. That's what we're doing. A little bit of fabrication. It's going along good. Lou's getting ready to weld this up. It's the start of a patch. This is how they're made, guys. It's a little bit of hand forming, a little bit of beating, a little bit of grinding. Before you know it, you got a patch. Let Lou tack this up real quick and we'll see what he's got. Lou laying down some tacks on his piece here. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and remove these bolts. I've already pulled the back 10 right here. Boy, there was some close ones. They such close quarters, they couldn't get a nut, so they had to cut one down. It's all right, it's coming apart. We've got, like I said, 30 more. Still got Lou up here on the fender. Boy, it's a beautiful day out today. He's getting down with this welder. Getting this patch all mocked up. We might want to put some stainless bolts back in this. I don't know. Ready?
Yep. Ugh.
This is the last one I can reach. I'll have to go to the other side. Yeah, go up here to these ones right here. Broke? Yeah.
Fun. Yeah. Whoa here. Okay. Yeah, stop for a second. One more again. There you go. All right. Back up front. I can't get that front one, so we'll go to the second one.
There.
Huh?
You're up there.
Yeah. The wall's got a lot of power, man. Alright, we slid these bed rails or the bed floor out real quick. And actually this thing's pretty solid in here. It's more solid than I thought it was. Like I said, there's a little few things I'm gonna doctor up and make this better, but I'm really pleased with just how solid these old rails really are. There's nothing to worry about. We can sandblast those and move right on. There's definitely a lot of old overspray and stuff in here, but that sandblaster will take care of all that, and then we can really see what's going on these panels. Try to get them fixed up a little better. Now we can fully see this panel. So this rear panel will get replaced, this one here. It's just completely gone. No big deal. Just tinkering along, guys. It's coming right along. Louie's still up here fabricating. Getting with it, building patches. He's got one partially built over here. This thing's gnarly looking. So it needs finished up and then put on. That's a good solid piece. So this is going to go, basically this is the piece you guys saw him hammering on a little bit ago. It's going to go right up in here where you see that's marked just like that. Now he'll do a better job putting it on than I can holding it here, but it definitely fits. Last bolts. All right, check this out. This is some custom fit stuff, I tell you. Look how close. As soon as the camera focuses here, that gearbox is to that exhaust. I don't think you could fit a fingernail between those two. Holy cow. Some awesome fabrication. Hey, it fit. It works. It runs and drives. That's awesome. That's definitely not the original engine, you know. So it's amazing that they got that big old thing to fit in there, but it's pretty wicked. All right, back outside doing a little sandblasting. We're just trying to make sure. I want you guys to see. Hopefully you can tell out here. You see the rust? So I've hit these lines here that you see were lines of rust. But all these little dots all over this thing, is that's all rust. So if we don't sandblast that all out, it will come back. You can epoxy it, try to make it last as long as you can, but I promise you, if you don't get all that little red oxide stuff out, it will come back. So that's what we're doing, guys, just slowly sandblasting and knocking some of this stuff out. Let's get with it. All right, that other fender is whacked. We got it completely done. And now I'm gonna get onto this one. This one's got a lot more crap in it. So, a lot more work here. This will probably take me the rest of the day, I'm sure. Let's get at it. All right, so right there is about 10 minutes. Gosh, this thing will shock the crap out of you after you blast it. I don't know if you guys can really see that or not. So, right there, that section took me about 10 minutes. It's very time consuming, but this is the right way to get all that stuff off and make sure we can epoxy this. Before we epoxy it, we'll be doing a little metal work, but some rot here and there. Have to shape out a couple pieces and weld those in. Make this a little nicer, and then we'll epoxy it up and then do our body work. But till then, probably 3 more days of sandblasting, not counting the cab. Yay.
All right, guys, so pretty much the day's about over. This is all I've got left. So I went ahead and filled her back up. We're gonna go ahead and knock that out. And then we've still got the other side. We'll get on that in the morning. That's this right here will probably wrap up day 7, I believe this is. So this is gonna be a 2-day vlog, day 6 and day 7. Got quite a bit done so far in about 7 days. Got it all stripped apart, got most of the paint off. So I feel like we're pretty well on track. It's gonna be a stretch. It's back down to 2 of us, just me and Lou for a while. So if you guys are learning anything, hit that like button. If you like what we do, here, like what you're seeing, you like our methods, how far we go, how in depth, how much, you know, work we show and the pride we show in what we do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. All right, guys, we'll catch you later on day 8. Thanks for watching.